Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. In this video we're going to talk about something you often see at the top of every RPG source code, but rarely gets explained in depth, the control options, also known as the H-spec in traditional RPG. These options tell the compiler how to handle things like activation groups, debugging, entry points, decimal formatting, and much more. Most of them affect the way your program is compiled, but some also impact runtime behavior. We will compare the old H-spec style with the modern CTL-OPT, explore the most useful options, and look at a few hidden gems that can help you write cleaner, more modern, and more efficient RPG code. So let's go. Well, let me first of all open two RPG sources. One is all-style RPG, and the other one is full-free format. As you know, I'm always using VS Code and Code4i to develop my programs. If you want to know some more about it, please check my channel. I have a big amount of videos talking about RPG, SQL, and all my examples are made using Code4i. Well, let me open it. And this one. Let me make it bigger. Okay. In older RPG, we use the H-spec to define compile time options. And originally, only one H-spec line was allowed. For example, this. But with RPG 4, this changed. You can now use multiple H-spec lines, and the compiler will process all of them. For example, we can write this here, this way. And this will work in the same way if it is only in one line. Okay. In full free format RPG, the modern way is using CTL-OPT. For example, look at this line. Well, CTL-OPT is more readable and flexible. You can write CTL-OPT and then write all options in the same line or in different lines as you wish. For example, we can write this way, or maybe we can write this way, and it will work in the same way. We can do this or put everything on the same line. It's just a matter of readability and personal style. Okay, some of these options can also be passed in the compile command. I will mention that when it is possible. There are a lot of options you can use to control how the compiler works or how your program behaves. I'll go over a few of them here, but as always, I recommend checking the IBMI documentation for your system version. There are tons of options out there, and some of them might really surprise you. Well, let's start with the program entry point. Let me put this in the same line. Well, if your program uses a procedure at its main entry, as in this case, okay, you can define it like this, using this option. You can set here main and the name of the procedure, the main procedure you're gonna use as an entry, okay? So for example, if you write here main proc, then this is telling the compiler to start execution with the main proc procedure. Of course, you can write here any name, okay? The compiler will look for that procedure to start the execution of the program, okay? Most of people uses the name main directly, okay? That's me. Well, if your module is just a collection of sub-procedures, like a service program, then you must write this no main, okay? These two options cannot be passed in the compile command. They must be set in the source, okay? Well, activation group options control how your program runs in the IDE environment. These are two important options, okay? The first one means that the program will run outside the default activation group. But you can write here yes. Okay, in that case, the default activation group will be used. But normally we will write this because this is required for ILE features like procedures. This other one, there are other values too, like name groups. You can watch a video in my channel named Activation Groups to learn about these options and the meaning of all this. Okay. You can set both of these in the compile command using default activation group and activation group option in the compile command. Well, personally, I always recommend using default activation group no for modern RPG programs. This way you can have best control over the execution of your programs, okay? But as I said, you can watch a video named Activation Groups that is in my channel where I speak about all of this, okay? Well, let me now talk about the debugging, okay? For easier debugging, we can use these options. Option, source statement, and this one, noDebugIO. Well, this option, source statement, shows the original source line numbers in error messages and in the debugger. This is very, in capital letters, very useful, okay? This other option, noDebugIO, skips stepping through file input-output during debugging. Less noise and faster stepping. If you have some experience, you will know that when you debug, if you don't have this option and you do an I/O operation with files, you have to press F10 many times to finish reading a record. This way, you are avoided, okay? Well, these two options can be set via the option parameter in the compile command too, okay? Well, let me speak about all the different options that we have. For example, we can use date format. We can use time format. Well, date format and time format controls how dates and times are formatted, okay? For example, oh, this is not written correctly, time this way. Well, for example, if you are using ISO format, okay, that is, as you know, year, four-digit year, month, and day. But if you are using an European format, that is day, month, and year, well, this way you can write here. If you want to use this format, you have to write here, year, okay? But there are different options, okay? The same happens with the time format. Well, there are other different, there are other options. For example, you can use decimal edit. Well, you can use decimal edit that sets the decimal separator, okay? This is handy for European locales, for example. You can use a dot or a comma if you want, okay? You can use this option, copyright, that, well, it is just for adding a copyright label. This is purely informational, okay? For example, when you compile the program, you can see this, this text inside the one, as a property of the object, okay? This is just, as I said, this is purely informational, okay? And this, there's another option that is binding directory. Well, that is telling the compiler which binding directory to use, okay? If you are using a binding directory to compile your program, if you are using, for example, a separate program or a different modules to put them together to create a program, okay? Well, this on the only this option, binding directory, can be set in the compile command. The other ones, the copyright, decimal edit, and the date and time format must be set in the source, okay? Well, let me remove all of them. And let me talk of other lesser known but very useful options. For example, you can have options like this, option noUNREF and noshowcpy. Well, noUNREF, this option is telling the compiler not to generate unused fields into the module. You know, the compiler always tells you that there are variables or fields not used in the program with a warning message. But if you compile by default, they are created. Okay, they are wasting space in memory, okay, because you are not using them. So this way, with this option, you can improve the compilation and the compiler will remove them from the final module, okay? Well, this other option, noshowcpy, this hides the copy content from the listing and debug views if you are copying source from other different sources, okay? Part of the code from different sources, okay? You can, this way you can hide that copy and your logs will be clean, okay? Well, other good option is this. Well, this option defines the precision of intermediate decimal calculations. Okay, this is very useful if you are using if you are making financial apps. Okay, if you're using numbers with a big amount of calculation with big number of decimal numbers, okay. If you're using decimal precision, it the calculation will be most accurate, okay. Well, these options that I have talked about, well, these options can only be set in the source, okay. They don't exist in the compile command. Well, now let me talk about the speed of my progress, the speed, how much faster my program runs. Well, if you need more speed, if you need more speed, you can try to optimize your code. And this way, you can do it, okay? But this option, you can control how the compiler optimizes your code. Well, you can set here the option known, that means no optimization, okay? This is best for debugging. And this is the default, it is not need to be written, okay? There's other way, this other option that is basic, okay? That is some optimization, and the other option is full, okay? This is best for production. Well, you can use numbers to set the optimization, okay? You can set a zero if you want to, the known option, okay, 10 if you want to make basic, and 20 that means the same thing as full, okay. All these settings, the optimization settings, can be set in the compilation command, okay. So in this video we have been talking about the RPG control options, both the classic H-spec and the modern CTL-OPT syntax. We have covered entry points, activation groups, debugging, runtime formatting, hidden features, and even performance studying. Some of these options can be passed to the compile command, others must be in the source, and now you know the difference. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video, and thanks for watching.